from our Eagan, Minnesota Manufacturing Distribution Center. Previously, we had shown you in a video how do you coat a screen properly to make it simple and easy for everyone to do. We want to move on, and we're actually going to move into how do we expose that screen and make our screen so that we can actually print a shirt. First thing is we have to have an exposure unit. This happens to be the BL1620, which has UV black lights in it. It has a simple on-off switch, so you're going to want to have your own timer. I'm going to use my timer on my phone. And then we have to have our artwork. So we've created our artwork on our computer, and we've printed our film positive out with an inkjet printer. This is RhinoJet. It's designed specifically for this purpose. This has a coated surface on it so that it holds the ink extremely well. You get a very dense film positive, which is absolutely necessary because you can't have any of the light penetrate that black area. So we put this in position, such as that. I then take my screen, which we had previously coated, put it in position here. Okay. I'm going to use a pressure plate. This has a melamine board with a foam on it. Put it on top of this because what I want to do is make sure I have really good contact. I want the film to be extremely tight against the screen itself. Put a couple of gallons of RhinoMite adhesive on there just to keep it down. And flip it on. Now in this particular case, we used our RhinoSol 500 emulsion. And I happen to know that from doing previous tests that this will take a 4-minute exposure. It'll vary depending on the type of exposure unit you have. So the first thing you have to do is make sure that you do a test. And you can do that by utilizing a film positive that's been pre-made for you that has different filters on it. And at that point, it'll filter out more and more light, and that way you can hone in on exactly the time that you need with the exposure unit you may have or the exposure unit you may buy, along with the particular emulsion that you're using. So when this is done, we'll move on to actually doing the developing of the screen itself. Okay, we've exposed the screen for our 4 minutes. We've turned it off. We just simply have to retrieve our screen. Then what we're going to do is we're going to walk out to our washout booth, and we're going to actually go through the developing process. Let's leave the film behind. And you might be able to see there's a latent image in here, and you can actually see that where the light did not hit it. So let's go out to the other side and take care of this. Okay, we're in the production area. And we're going to set our screen in. This happens to be a RhinoClean washout booth. And the first thing I'm going to do is wet it down. Let's turn the lever on here. Wet it down on both sides. Now I'm using a pressure washer here, but I haven't turned it on yet. So I just want to get it wet. Washer. I like to do it that way because some people use just a garden hose. I have this on a wide fan. I also have it so that it is lower pressure. I'm going to back off from the area as well. Otherwise, you might damage your screen. So, you turn this on. As you can see, you should be able to see that you have your image in there. Softening up that area that was not exposed because our RhinoJet film blocked all of that area. Now I'm watching this from the non-speed side at the bottom of the screen. There we go, now it's all coming out. Flip it over. over because I do want to wash from both sides. Now, I didn't have the backlight on. Of course, washout booths all come with backlights. Makes it a lot easier when you're doing your job so you can see what you're doing. But I didn't put it on because it's pretty hard for the camera to pick it up with the light behind it. But basically, we now have our screen. And with a little final wash. From there, we would move on. Once it's dry, we have to block out all of this area around here, and that can be done in a variety of ways. One, you can use a blockout, such as RhinoBlock, or you can actually tape it out. Some people will do both. Just depends on what your system is set up for in your shop. That's how you expose and develop a screen. So, until the next time, you know where to find us. Thanks for watching.